As you can see, we're in the heart of Dutch politics. My name is Esther Ouwehand. I'm a member of parliament for the Animal Rights Party for 5 years now. And one of my big concerns are animal testing. And I've been asked to reflect on the necessity of systematic reviews. The societal interest for animal welfare is continuously growing. It's not a new development. Throughout history, people have been concerned about the way people treat animals, and throughout philosophy, we've noticed that there are a lot of questions to be asked about the way we should deal with animals. Can we use them for everything we like to? The interest for the rights of animals and the welfare of animals is growing, and you can see that all around us. Not only are we more concerned about our own pets, but there is growing awareness about the welfare and the rights of animals that are out of our sight in factory farming and livestock farming, and the animals we use in animal testing in laboratories. So it makes common sense that we should ask the moral questions. Do we have a right to use animals, make them sick, kill them for our own health? And there are scientific questions to ask about animal testing. So when it comes to animal testing, there are two types of questions that are closely related. The most important one is the moral dilemma that will, in my view, will never disappear as long as we test on animals in our society. But there's also the scientific perspective, and that focuses on the question whether the animal model is a good model for knowledge on human health. And the question about reliability and the scientific use of the animal model has long been avoided by scientists and by organizations that test on animals. But society and politics are no longer willing to blindly accept the authority of the scientists. So there are questions to be raised and to be answered about the scientific value of the animal model. Science is built on critical attitudes, and critical attitudes must be visible when research is concerned that raises moral dilemmas. And we as politicians, frankly, are wondering why systematic reviews are common practice in medical research, in common research, but not for animal testing. So a growing number of politicians, not only from our own party, Party for the Rights of Animals, but the Socialist Party, the Liberal Democrats, the Green Left Party, the Democratic Party, feel that the use of systematic reviews must be obligatory for animal testing as well. And I hope that the visitors of the Congress and science in general will conclude the same. So, in my view, we cannot do without systematic reviews in animal testing any longer. Hopefully, you'll say the same.